just like Clara, sipping champagne, can't you see me? In the middle of a dance floor. That could be me, that could be me, doing things like Clara, flirting madly, looking dreamy. These are things you take a chance for. It must be great to be called the It Girl. Your face on every magazine. That's where I'm gonna end up one day. Trust me.
Bonnie Elizabeth Parker, it is your father's funeral.
No. No, it's not.
Bonnie.
I don't want to go in there.
Baby.
Leave me alone.
Let's go, baby.
Charles Parker was a beloved husband to Emma and a devoted father to sweet Bonnie, who was baptized here just a few months ago on her 10th birthday. And now, let us bow our heads in prayer. The soul of Charles Parker is now with Jesus Christ and will rise again with Christ's second coming, when body, soul, and spirit will be reunited to be glorified forever.
The main attraction at the picture show. Like Clara Bow. Like Clara.
I wanna live the life of an outlaw. I'm gonna be like Billy the Kid.
Your father gone, we can't afford to stay in Rowena.
Why here?
Because your Grandma Mary was kind enough to take us in. God, this place is a shithole.
I'll be ready when I switch to Clara. Riding horses, going steady with the guy who owns a jazz bar.
Deputy, please don't take him.
This is the third time your boy's had a run-in with the law. First time he said it wasn't him, he was here with you.
Like my
against
mom,
my
pa.
Better judgment, I took your word. Second time, when
I
he was identified by a witness, he said you take care of it. Now, I don't know how you handled
no
it. Obviously had
no
effect. Now, I'm going to have to
my
take
way. He's only 12. You can't put him in jail.
I can throw him in juvenile detention.
You step up in the damn tent we're living in. You are too young to be getting married.
I am 15, Mama.
Getting married to Roy is not going to get you out of this bog.
He promised we'd all move to California.
And you think he can do that?
I got me a publicity photo.
This is nice.
They say when you're a star in the movies, you get to keep the clothes you wear. Big stars make $30 a week.
Jesus!
I wanna be her, dressed in style like Clara.
reflection at the picture show. Attraction at the picture show.
Bang, bang, you're dead. Bang, bang, you're dead.
Ain't nothing I can do with the gun.
Marvin Ivan Barrow, Clyde Chestnut Barrow, you've been found guilty on one count of burglary and two counts of auto theft. You are both hereby sentenced to 2 years at the McLennan County Jail.
Gonna be the guy kids look up to. I'll cut their hair the way I cut mine. Capone was just like me when he started. Some guy, he made it big, and so will I.
It must be great to be called the It's-a-girl.
That isn't what they call me. Than a hero.
But one day soon.
Sweet cheeks, is it true that for the right price, a fella can get a little something that's not on the menu?
For the right price, a fella can get almost anything these days.
You taking an OU?
Go to hell.
Hiya, Bonnie.
Hey, Ted. Apple pie and coffee?
Thank you. Oh. Hey, listen, a friend of mine, Bob Mayfield, is having a party Saturday night. Went to Smith High School when we were there. Maybe you remember him?
I don't think so.
Well, I was thinking maybe you'd want to go.
Sure. They gonna have a piano?
Pretty sure it's gonna be a whole band.
Hey, Ted! Sheriff's on the phone.
I'll pick you up Saturday at 7.
A whole band. It must be great to be called the It Girl. That isn't what they're calling me. But one day soon, I bet you they will. Damn it! Damn it, damn it, damn it!
Hey, engine trouble?
Engine trouble, tire trouble, oil trouble?
Sounds like you and me got the same car. Goes through oil like a preacher to whiskey, huh?
Yeah.
How about I see if I can fix it up for you, and then maybe you can give me a lift into West Dallas?
Sure. Thanks. You live in the Devil's Back Porch?
Not for much longer.
I don't know anybody ever moved out of West Dallas.
Well, you do now. Clyde Barrow.
Bonnie Parker.
Why, you got a beautiful smile. Bet you hear that all the time.
Why, yes, I do.
Me too.
So where are you moving to?
Anywhere I want. Just like the legendary Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid? He was an outlaw.
Why, yes, he was.
And wasn't Billy the Kid ambushed and killed by some sheriff?
He wasn't ambushed. He died an old man in the arms of a young woman.
I'm pretty sure he was gunned down in some hotel room.
It don't matter. I got plans.
Everybody's got plans.
Everybody's got dreams. I got plans. The men in this town, living, dying, are forgotten, and it doesn't seem to scare them. I can't wait to get away, away from the drought, from the homeless and the hungry, where they talk about foreclosures every hot and dusty day. I don't intend to waste my life around here. I got it all mapped.
for health and fame. Everyone will know my name.
Pull three jobs. What does that mean?
What do you think it means?
Just like Billy the Kid and Mr. Capone, every kid will idolize Clyde Barrow. One thing, young lady, I guarantee that this world will remember me. Yes, this world will remember me. Don't you think it's time that you lost that egg-stained apron and wore something made to set it from a fine Manhattan store? See, I can see you in a car with your old driver. You were heading to your penthouse that would overlook the shore. Your face should be up on a silver screen. You've got that it girl look.
I can't believe that you see that in me. I always knew I'd be a star. How intelligent you are.
We are wasted around here. We're too big for this place. We weren't born to live and die.
Me and my brother did just bust out of jail, so probably. You don't got to worry about me, because I've been to jail.
I know plenty of men who've been to jail.
How many you know busted out?
What were you in for?
Robbery, auto theft, a few things, actually. I like to keep busy. So, what do you say about that lift in West Dallas?
The police are looking for you.
They ain't gonna find me. By this time tomorrow, I'll be 500 miles away. I just want to see my folks before I go.
Okay.
Yes, this world will remember me.
Ahem.
Are you crazy? Busting out of jail?
No, baby.
Don't you now, baby me. How did you let Clyde talk you into fugitiving?
It was my idea.
Yours?
Yeah.
How could you go and do this? Here I am praying that they'll shorten your sentence.
Well, your prayers are answered. This made it real short.
No. Shit! Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
I'm leaving.
You sit down. You. Give me this. Put this on. Maxie. Everybody just relax. I was not here. Purse.
Beautiful day.
Mm-hmm. Evening, ladies.
Evening, Sheriff.
I'm here about your husband, Marvin, a.k.a. Buck Barrow. You heard from him?
Oh, not since he got himself arrested. I don't have room for a man like that in my life. You will find him in McLennan County Jail.
No, you won't.
What?
He should be sitting there. But he ain't.
What?
Your husband and his brother got in their heads to escape.
What?
You see him, or you know anything of his whereabouts. You call the Dallas County Sheriff's Office right away. You hear?
Of course.
You have a good evening, ladies. Sorry to interrupt your hair doings.
Bye. Oh, my God.
Baby, baby, you were fantastic.
I am having a heart attack. They are not going to stop looking, Buck.
Mm. Well, they never do.
That's right.
Mm. They're going to get you.
They ain't never going to get me. Maybe we move to New Mexico.
Oh, how romantic.
How beautiful.
Mm, they're going to get him.
Mm. Right, baby? You're always on about coming to New Mexico.
That wouldn't be going to New Mexico. It'd be running from West Dallas.
She has got a point.
Still, I hear New Mexico's real nice.
They're going to get you. Do you always want to be like your brother, running from the law, looking over your shoulder? I love you, Daddy. I love you more than life itself, but we cannot start fresh like that.
That's right.
Amen.
We start Thank fresh you, when you are free in the eyes of the law and saved in the eyes of God.
Praise Amen. Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, twice. Amen. We can't spend our whole lives hiding, Buck. That ain't no way to live. It is time to wipe the slate clean, ask the good Lord to forgive.
Amen.
Lord. Amen.
You gotta serve your sentence without fail. Buck, you are going back to jail.
My baby.
Won't be scared to turn the corner or to open our front door. When you're on the side of justice, you ain't nervous of the law. Now pull yourself together because you
dessert. Bring your face close to mine and just let me inhale.
Look, you are going back to jail.
Okay.
We're going to call the sheriff and tell him you're turning yourself in right after church tomorrow. It's going to be just as hard on me, Daddy. Trish, you know what it's like having a husband in jail. Tell him how hard it is not having Joe around.
Are you kidding? It's a treat to get my nails done and have time to read a book. Trisha beats washing out his long johns. It's a pleasure not to cook. Thank God those prison walls are much too tall to scale. My darling's nice and safe in jail.
I don't want her coming around here no more.
Stella's husband's been in jail for 2 years now, and she is miserable without her man.
Oh, yeah.
At first, I really missed him. I thought I would waste away. Then I met this boy from Tucson, and he owned a Chevrolet.
Oh, no.
He had a lot of things in my boy bag.
Okay,
like teeth and hair and cash to be eaten.
I think you're done.
I now got lots of habits I can't yeah. I gotta keep him locked in jail. Keep him
see that I ain't married to some bum. It will be hard for us, but we'll come through.
I can't believe what you are asking me to do.
One thing's for certain, our love won't go stay.
Jesus Christ, close your eyes.
Bitch, I ain't going back.
Yes, Buck, you're going back. Tomorrow he'll be back in jail.
Grocery store. Can't do nothing without cash. Once I get that, I hightail it to another state.
somewhere in the Northeast. Cops can't cross state lines, and they ain't gonna be looking for me in Ohio or New York. After I got that, I'm a free man. I can live the way I like. And you know what?
What?
You're gonna come with me.
What makes you so sure?
The smile.
Just because I'm smiling doesn't mean...
I was talking about mine.
I should get home. And you want to see your folks?
They can wait. What are you writing?
A poem.
What kind of poem?
Kind that's gonna be published.
Wow.
Yeah. You're gonna see my face in the movies and my poems in the magazine. Poetry by Bonnie Parker and a beautiful picture of me to go alongside it. Like this one. That's what you call a glamour shot.
This is the most beautiful picture I've ever seen.
It's a little old now, but I'm gonna get a new one. In a nice hat. I look good in hats. I got a hat face.
Read me a poem.
You like poetry?
When it's coming out of your mouth.
Okay. Billy rode on a pinto horse. Billy the Kid, I mean.
I love Billy the Kid.
I know. And he met Clyde Barrow riding in a little gray...
You wrote about me? You wrote a poem about me? Oh, sugar, you are so in love.
Billy said to the Barrow boy, is this the way you ride? In a
car... Ford Deluxe sedan.
Are you going to interrupt my every line?
I'm sorry.
I can't read if you're going
to
do that.
I didn't mean to.
There's a rhythm, a flow to these things.
I'm sorry.
I appreciate the enthusiasm, but...
My lips are sealed.
Billy said to the Barrow boy, is this the way you ride? In a car that does its 90 per, machine guns at each side?
Dang.
I only had my pinto horse and my six gun tried and true. I could shoot, but they got me. And someday they will get you.
What are you writing that for? That's a lousy thing to write.
It's dramatic.
It's stupid.
Don't you call my poetry stupid.
It is when you write stuff like that.
You don't know crap
about
poetry. They
ain't never gonna get me.
I'm gonna be famous for my poetry and my acting career. Don't you call my poetry stupid just because you're a thick-head and can't appreciate it.
Man, I want you right now.
Should have thought of that before you called my poetry stupid. Don't laugh at me. I mean it. I'm gonna be famous. I'm gonna be a poet and an actress and a singer.
A singer, huh? Let me hear something.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on, I wanna hear you sing. Well, unless that's also gonna be about me getting shot up. Come on, you're in a nightclub in that there Atlantic City. Me and Capone sitting ringside. The crowd's going crazy. Bonnie, Bonnie.
About a dance, what do you say? I got some moves that I'd love to show ya. Let's find a spot and dance the night away. How about a dance? Let me get to know you. Can't beat a band to lift your spirits high. You look so handsome. How about a dance? Let's make a start. Music like this can really throw you. You lose the blues and you may lose your heart.
Your mama's home?
It's me, Mama.
Why didn't you tell me
what
your mom?
What on earth are you? Who are you?
I'm a...
Mama, this is Clyde Barrow. He's the cousin of my friend, Charlene's.
Evening, Miss Parker.
What are you doing in my house this time of the evening?
I'm a...
He's just on his way to Ohio to begin a job in printing.
Printing, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Not many men have jobs these days.
No, ma'am.
You should count yourself very lucky.
I do. Who plays the ute?
My husband did. God rest his soul.
Amen.
That's nice. Where'd you learn to play?
A color boy taught me when we lived out under the viaduct.
You lived in one of those camps?
Pa was a sharecropper over in Henderson County when the land dried up. We moved here to West Ellis and lived in a tent under the Oak Cliff Viaduct for near 3 years.
Well, Clyde, you may sleep on the sofa. There's an extra sheet in the bedroom. I'm afraid we don't have an extra blanket or a pillow.
That's okay.
Bonnie, I expect you upstairs very quickly.
Yes, Mama.
Almost immediately.
Mama!
Your husband will be home, you know.
You got a husband?
Baby.
I mean, that's something you ought to tell a fella.
I had a husband. Went to jail about 3 years ago.
Still there?
No. Just not interested in being a husband. Is that really what you want to talk about right now?
You expecting anybody?
No.
Shit, it's the laws. Meet me tomorrow over in Harrison, 145 Oak Grove. Whistle or throw something at the second floor window on the corner.
Ted, what are you doing here?
Following some leads on a break-in. Since I was in the neighborhood, figured I'd stop by. Make sure you and your ma are okay.
We're fine. Thanks, Ted.
Jeez. Last time I was in this house was when your grandma died.
It was a long time ago.
You know, that was the first dead body I ever saw. I mean, she was wearing lots of makeup and all, but you could still see she was dead.
I hated seeing her like that.
You know, I remember how we both hid under your front porch.
Eating buttermilk pie.
Playing cards. So I'll pick you up at Saturday at 7.
Ted.
You keep this door locked, all right?
All right, Ted.
I think folk will be shocked to learn just how unchristian you are in bed, Mrs. Barrow.
Daddy, hush that mouth of yours.
I'm going to miss that over the next 8 months.
It's going to fly by, you'll see. And I'll work. Women always find money to get their hair done. Eleanor's kids haven't had real milk in 2 years, and she gets her color done every 2 months.
I love you, Blanche.
I love you too, Daddy. What in the world?
It's Clyde!
Marvin Ivan Barrow, have you turned our home into a criminal rendezvous point?
Oh, come on, it's just Clyde.
Which makes this a criminal rendezvous point.
He's my brother.
That boy puts hell in hello. You two are like children with your flying bottles and your secret knocks.
Hey.
Hey.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
Well, you look like shit.
Slept in the woods. You seen the papers today?
Book and Clyde on Barrett Time. What the hell does that mean?
It means we're a front page headline, right next to Al Capone.
Dang.
Remember when we saw Capone driving through town middle of the afternoon and I...
What? Model T Roadster?
That's gonna be us, Buck, driving the road in a Model T. Are you seeing a picture of one of those MGs they got over in Europe?
They got a 4-speed gearbox with a top speed of 65 miles an hour.
Dang.
Ain't no car too smart for me. Got the whole thing figured out. Two-door hardtop Model T, limousine or runabout. Put me behind the wheel and stand well back. Like a Cracker Jack, I'll get your heart pumping.
Ain't no car that you can't drive. I will bet my life on that. Hot rod, roadster, pickup truck, 40 miles in nothing flat.
Ain't nothing better than a drive through town with the pedal down. Watch the old folk jump in. When I drive, I'm in love, I'm alive. And I forget about everything I hate. When I drive, I can read 65. I won't play the law, no mind. They'll always be behind. And brother, that feels great.
Hey, look, there's danger up ahead. Here comes a curve.
Quit tugging out my sleeve, just hold your nerve. Give me a full tank and an open road, and watch me explode. Hey, look at me, I'm driving. When I drive, I'm in love, I'm alive. And I forget about everything I hate.
When I drive, when you drive, life just flies when you drive. We are the heroes who the people look up to, and brother, that feels great.
I can flow,
I can fly,
This is how,
I wanna live, I wanna die. I'm in love, I'm alive,
when I drive.
She's here.
Who's here, Clyde? Clyde!
Is he gone?
I think he's coming back.
Why?
I think he went outside to get a girl.
A girl?
That's what he said.
When on earth did Clyde find the time to meet some tart?
Excuse me?
This here is my brother, Book.
Pleased to meet you.
And this here is Bonnie Parker.
Nice meeting you.
Ahem. Ahem.
And this here is my sister-in-law, Blanche.
Pleasure. All mine.
How you feeling, Buck? You feeling strong?
Why?
I got some ideas.
What kind of ideas?
Buck.
Ideas that are gonna get you out of this dump. No offense, Blanche.
Buck.
So I figure, first thing, we hit up some place with a payroll. Gas station, clothing store.
Buck.
What is your problem, woman?
Tell him.
Tell me what?
I kind of got a plan, too.
Okay, let's hear it.
I'm going back to prison.
You're going back to where?
I'm going back to prison.
I'd swear it sounds like you're saying prison.
Buck has decided to go back and finish his sentence. And if you had any sense, you'd do the same.
What is she talking about?
Blanche decided, the both of us, you know, that it would be best for me to go back and finish out my sentence. But we could drive after that.
I feel like I'm losing my mind here.
No running, no hiding, no bottles flying out through windows.
Maybe you should go back, too. How long would it be?
Going back ain't what I do.
It's the only way to wipe the slate clean.
You can wipe all you want. It ain't never going to be clean. The law's been coming after us since we was kids.
You've been stealing since you were kids.
Even when we didn't.
That's true.
How many times they come by our tent and haul us out for no damn reason?
Plenty.
And when I worked over at Mason's...
For a week?
That's true, too.
They'd come by and pat me down every day right in front of customers. Now, how's a guy supposed to keep a job like that? Don't matter what we do, Blanche, the law's gonna keep coming after us.
Forgiveness from the Lord, Clyde. It's the only way you can be truly set free.
I ain't never gonna be free, Blanche. Freedom is something I gotta steal. No, I'm out of here. So what's it gonna be, Buck?
I'm going back, Clyde.
And what are you gonna do when you get out, huh? You're gonna come back here? And what? Work picking up scrap metal for 3 cents a load? Or maybe with Pa over at the gas station, praying somebody rich enough to steal on a car stops in. And what are you going to eat, huh? I'm going to be in charge of my own life, out on the open road, living the way I want. You have a nice time locked up in that cage. Let's go, sugar.
Maybe your brother has the right idea. Maybe going back...
Clyde Barrow ain't never going to set foot inside a prison again.
So maybe we go someplace else. We want to get out of Dallas anyway. You could get a job someplace and work. I want you to be a man, honey, not a thug.
Don't you ever talk that way to me.
Don't you ever lay your hands on me, baby.
My advice to you is to stay as far away from that man as possible. Don't you look at me like that, Daddy. You know I'm right. If he wants to descend into the depths of hell, he does not need to take anyone else down there with him. Not you, not me, and not that poor misguided trash he picked up last night.
I thought you said it was wrong to judge people.
That was not a judgment. It was an observation.
God's arms are always open. He'll not turn you away. He is there to lead the way for you through each night and day. God's arms are always open. Your voice is always heard. Even though your prayers are silent prayers, He hears every word. Shine.
His light will shine.
Peace will come to you. God's arms are always open, and everyone's His friend. When you find Him, all your darkest fears will come.
Fears come to an end.
Run to His arms when you seek salvation. Wash your sins away.
Amen.
This is the time for some jubilation. Come to Him today.
Yes,
Jesus. God doesn't speak of retribution. Everyone's soul is saved.
Hallelujah.
He will forgive even those who've misbehaved.
Yeah.
Undo the chains that you've tied around you. Your hands hold the key.
Your hands hold the key.
You're gonna feel things that will astound you. Soon you will be free.
Soon you will be free.
Be proud to join in this congregation. Take a walk in the sun. Will they hold the key? No more retribution.
God's arms.
No, no.
God's arms.
Keys in the seat and step away from the car. You see this gun, mister? I will blow your... Are those leather seats? Dang, this is a beautiful car. You were one lucky fella. Well, you know, until now.
You got
guns.
They're always open. You got
run.
He'll set you free.
Set you free.
That is one beautiful dress. Bonnie is gonna love that dress. Come on, put it in the bag. Come on. You got a gift card? To Bonnie. I can't wait to rip this off you.
You got guns. They're always open. You got
run.
Run
to him.
He'll set you free.
He'll set you free.
Come on, join
God's arms.
This congregation.
Always open.
Day by day.
Run to him.
He holds the key.
He holds the key.
Now come on, children.
God's arms.
Come on, children.
God's arms.
Keep your hands in the air. Finger off the trigger, son. Now place the gun on the ground. Step away from the weapon. Cuff him.
Guns always open.
Guns
always open.
They're always
open. Guns always open.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Get by. You'll find something.
Doing what?
I don't know, but the good Lord
will... screw the good Lord.
But...
The good Lord ain't done nothing for nobody I know. And he's letting the guards beat the shit out of Clyde.
Well, the good Lord knows better than anybody that Clyde needs a good shit-kicking.
You swear you've been faithful to me, Trish?
I swear.
If I ever find out you cheated on me...
Honey, I promise, you will never find out that I cheated on you.
Bonnie?
Ted.
You missed some party Saturday night.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I mean to call by the diner this week, but I'm busy as hell. Evictions mostly. Thought maybe you'd want to make it up to me.
Ted.
Let me take you out to dinner tomorrow night.
I don't know, Ted. I mean, I don't think I can.
What are you doing here?
Just visiting somebody.
Who?
Clyde Barrow.
Clyde Barrow, you know him?
He's a friend of a friend.
Listen, I don't know who your friend is, but you listen to me. You do yourself a favor and keep a good distance. Clyde Barrow is a bad seed.
Thanks for the advice, Ted.
Bonnie, how you doing, sugar?
How am I doing? I'm miserable without you. I can't think of nothing else but you.
I'm sorry you gotta go through this.
When you get out of here, you are going straight, you understand?
I got a friend who knows a guy in construction up in Worcester, Mass.
I'd go anywhere on this earth with you, baby.
And if that don't work out, they got places to rob up there, just same as here.
No more holdups, baby. You have got to start clean.
Okay, sugar.
I brought you a picture, baby.
I give you fair warning, he's no bed of roses, sweet Bonnie. I can't see him finding the time to raise children, hell no. He's wild and he's reckless, ain't nothing but trouble. You're better without him. You think hard, sweet Bonnie,
and then you should think once again. We both know that you can do better than him. Why, you deserve someone who's there all the time, someone who thinks crime don't pay. I still see the snowy white dress you wore, playing the angel in some dumb school play. For a while I thought that you would fly away. I still see the apple cheek girl you were, hiding in treetops and feeding the birds, making up rhymes how you love pretty words. You deserve someone who people respect, a man who is rich and smart, someone who's known in all the right places, knows the good book by heart. But I know, you won't do better than me. No, not when it comes down to love that is true. There's no man who could love you.
Look, I'm here, Charles Blanche.
I pray the good Lord brings my daddy home to me tomorrow.
I will. Blanche?
What?
I just hate to see you get hurt, honey.
I'm not gonna.
That man of yours has been in and out of jail 10 times.
7.
All I'm saying is chances are.
I asked you to pray, Eleanor, not to judge. If you can't do that.
I'm sorry. Charlie says he's only going to be able to keep me on another week. There just aren't
enough. Margaret Cummins said she saw you get on a bus to Eagle Rock yesterday.
Must have been someone else. Someone who looks like me.
No, she was pretty sure it was you.
I really don't see.
Why are you lying to me, Bonnie? What is so awful that's causing my daughter to lie to her mama?
I'm in love, Mama.
You're married.
You and me both know Roy ain't ever coming back. And I wouldn't want him if he did.
How'd you meet a boy that lives in Eagle Rock?
He doesn't live there. He's just staying there for a short time.
Well, there's nothing in Eagle Rock except the penitentiary. Bonnie Parker, are you flirting with the convict?
I'm not flirting.
What is going through your mind?
I love him, Ma.
You love who? Who do you love?
Clyde Barrow.
Clyde Barrow. The boy who spent the night at our home? You said he was headed up north to a job.
I'm in love with him, Ma.
You don't know him, and what you do know ain't so good.
I know him. I know everything.
He's a convict you met a few months ago.
You always said you and Daddy was love at first sight.
Don't you dare compare some convict with your father. Your daddy was a fine, upstanding citizen. He was a good father to you, a good husband to me. Don't you ever compare your father to a convict. I'll see you at home.
I know my heart. I don't care what people say. All I know is that I've never felt like this. And besides, I wouldn't change him if I could. No man's all good.
I always knew what I was taking on. If my man will never fall in line, I'm glad he's mine. 'Cause you love who you love, and you can't help how you're made. You don't have no say, your heart decides. It's that simple, I'm afraid. Yes, you love who you love. Common sense may say it's wrong. There's a part of him you know is wild. Maybe that's what made you love him all along.
I only care that he's mine and I am his. There ain't no rules, that's how.
Chestnut Barrel, you've been found guilty on 7 counts of burglary over $50, and are charged to 2 years on each count.
What does that mean?
Plus an additional 2 years for your escape.
I don't understand.
For a total of 16 years at the Eastern Penitentiary.
No!
Mom! Away from her!
My boy, do not hurt my baby!
Take him.
I'm sorry, Mom.
I love you, baby.
I love you too, sugar.
I think this sends a strong message that in these hard times, we will not tolerate criminal behavior of any kind. Clyde Barrow will be serving 16 years hard labor at Eastern Penitentiary.
Beautiful.
I don't feel beautiful. I don't feel anything but sad.
You're making the right decision. It's been 6 months now since that hoodlum of yours...
Stop calling him that.
...has been in jail.
I will never love anybody the way I love Clyde, Mama.
Honey, you think your father was the first man I ever fell in love with? Before I was your mama, I was a girl. But I understood that love can be blind. And in this life, you need to see clearly. You need to find a stable, responsible young man who can provide for you all the things you deserve, darling. And then love, real love, comes from that.
I'm too young for a brooch, Mama.
That is your grandmother's brooch.
That is my point.
You're making the best decision. The heart's not always right, Bonnie.
Hiya, Bonnie.
Hiya, Ted.
I like your brooch.
Keep him away from me.
Who? Ed Crowder? Seems like a nice enough fella to me.
He's a model prisoner. You know what he's doing to me. I'm begging you.
Ed Crowder's just being friendly. He likes you. You should take that as a compliment.
I can't take no more of this. This nightmare has to end in this God-forsaken place. Death would be a welcome friend. I could pay a crooked guard to kill me. Yeah, that's it. Better that than 16 years dying slowly, bit by bit. All I did was rob a few stores. Justice here don't fit the crime. I've been broken by the devil. Justice is a waste of time. I won't get to heaven. Why?
Hey, Clyde, your other girlfriend's here.
Oh, my God, Clyde. Clyde, what happened to your face? What's going on? Baby, can I do something? Can I complain? Somebody help him!
There's a gun under the pump at the gas station. Get it to me.
What seems to be the problem?
Look at him.
Yeah, heard he took a pretty bad fall down the stairs to the yard.
That doesn't happen from a fall. That doesn't happen by accident.
Visiting time is over.
Baby, just give me what I ask.
Get your hands off me. I'm coming by here every day. Every day.
I'll be back to get you later. Ed Crowder wants to see you again.
He'll see me, but it's the last time. That filthy scum has gotta go by tonight. It will be over when I strike the fatal blow. No way out. I gotta do this. Him or me? Okay, let's play. Never care. Heaven, so let's raise a little hell.
some things for Clyde. There's a pair of shoes and a Bible.
Thank you.
I don't know what he'd do without you. You're the one ray of sunshine he's got in his whole life.
Thanks.
Well, who would have thought that a waitress from Rowena would have had the balls to bust me out with my old 45? And who would have thought that a farm boy from Tilico could outsmart the smartest lawman and walk out of here alive?
Stop. Give me the bag. Wait a minute. I gotta search you.
You done?
No.
Are you having yourself a nice time?
Get your arms up. What's this?
My mama doesn't like me smoking.
She got 5 minutes.
My name is gonna make the history books. Too bad I won't be here. I may have started out with small time crow. In a year or two, I'll be as known as Chicago's Al Capone.
Bye, baby.
See you soon, sugar. Thanks to you, Bonnie, babe, I can make plans again. I got lots of reasons to keep living. It's true that love set you free, and this world will remember me.
With who?
A friend.
With who?
I don't know.
Clyde Barrow?
No, that boy's in prison.
No, he's not. He busted out last night.
Said you'd go straight, Clyde. I wanna be in movies. I can't name one movie star who's doing robberies on the side. I know in my heart, babe, that Hollywood is calling. How can I be in the spotlight if we always have to hide?
We'll need some dough to get to Hollywood. One or two jobs should do.
But after that, we will be done for good.
Babe, when Hollywood gets hold of you, they'll be saying, Clara, who?
Blanche, come here, look at this. Front page.
What?
He busted out. Clara busted out. Son of a bitch!
I have no interest in your brother's doings.
It don't make sense.
How else did Clyde Barrow get a gun smuggled in?
I don't know, but Bonnie's no criminal. I know her. I'm telling you, she's innocent.
So where is she?
The mom said she went to Utah.
And that's your proof?
I know her. Bonnie, she's a good girl. A straight A student. She's got a job. It don't make sense.
The only one who could have done it.
I know her.
Maybe you don't!
Clyde somehow smuggled a gun into prison and demanded he be set free. He's free, Vance.
He's a fugitive.
They ain't ever going to catch Clyde. No one drives like him. Dang, he's famous.
No need to rush. Everybody gets their autograph. Hell of a ride will be the word on our epitaph. To live the legends that we will be. And that's okay with me. Every place that we go, folks will turn their heads. They'll be hollering from Dodge to Denver. We are the pair that they'll discuss. Yes, this world will remember us. We are making dang sure that we leave our mark. You don't leave your mark by digging ditches. No wonder we're who they'll discuss. Yes, this world will remember us. This dang world will remember us.
I don't care how hard the hardship, no one has the right to steal, and you cannot buy your soul back. God don't make that kind of deal. When your prayers all go unanswered, and the dust is getting worse, and you live near open sewers with just pennies in your purse, that is when the good Lord will become your Savior. He will lead you to the light. We are all God's children, His arms always open. We must all do what is right. You may be in debt, wake up in a sweat, but let's not forget you were made.
Okay to do this?
Wait a minute. Did you see the movie Shadow of the Law?
No.
Clara Bow has no choice but to join a criminal gang. So she pretends to go crooked, but really she's carefully plotting.
Bonnie!
It's okay. I'm ready now.
Clyde ain't ever gonna stay in prison.
Gibson takes some rock again.
Folks are calling him a hero.
Sure, they robbed some men, and they will again. Poor kids of a ten, they were made in America.
They had
holes in every shoe. No dream can come true.
They stole wooden shoe.
Nobody with their hands lower than their ears. Now move along over here. Not you. Okay, come on. Open up the register. Come on. All of it.
Just think about it.
Shut up. You got a safe?
No.
Are you sure?
Under the register.
Come on, open it. Come
on. My hands are shaking.
Come on.
Move it out, shoot.
Jesus.
Now. Raise your hands and put the gun down.
How can I put the gun down if I'm raising my hands?
You know what I mean. Put the gun on the ground and put your hands in the air.
What if I say no?
Everybody out!
Nobody move! Looks like we got ourselves a standoff.
Drop the weapon.
You sure you got what it takes to pull the trigger?
You really want to find out?
No, I'm gonna walk out of here.
Not gonna happen.
Listen to me, deputy.
Drop the gun!
Jesus, Clyde, you scared the life out of me. Come here, baby. Clyde, what's going on? Clyde, what happened? Clyde, look at me.
I was holding up a grocery store over in Hillsboro. Easy money, you know? In and out, nobody gets hurt. A grocery store. And then this stupid idiot cop comes in trying to be the hero.
Clyde?
He had his gun right on me.
What happened, Clyde?
I had no time.
What happened?
No.
It was him or me, babe.
I can't stay.
I gotta get out now while I still can, while I'm still in the clear. The dream is done, it's over now. Gotta get me out of here.
Don't say that, we're both in shock. We need to think this through. It ain't my fault, I had no choice. Nothing I could do.
With that bullet, you shot him and you shot me. Clyde, how stupid can you be?
It's too late to turn the clock back. I would do it if I could. We can talk about this forever, but it still won't do no good. I wouldn't hurt you for the world, babe, but we'll get through this somehow.
I'll get through this cause I'm leaving. Not too late to turn back now. I thought I'd sign with MGM and I won't see that dream die.
I don't give a damn about MGM and now don't you say goodbye. How can you think of leaving? Get those thoughts out of your head. Cause you ain't going nowhere.
But I meant what I said.
You come here right now, give me that body smile. Babe, I need to see that smile. It's too late to say I'm sorry. It's too late for all of that. I cannot change what has happened. Let's face what we're looking at. You got every right to be mad, but let's move on. It's too late to turn back.
Grocery store in Hillsboro I'm gonna hit. Easy money, in, out, nobody gets hurt. I figure we can rob my first bank next week. I'm casing out a couple of places. I will keep in touch, and I will try to see you and the folks. Your brother, Clyde. Say what you want about Clyde, but he never forgets family.
Maybe you could ask him to try harder.
Don't you ever want it just a little bit, baby?
Want what?
All the things you can't have.
I have everything that I want. And it pains me that you don't, Daddy.
I have all the things I want, too, but there's still things I want. And I'd like to give you everything in the world.
Stop that. I don't have room for everything in the world.
Nice clothes. Someone doing your hair. Good food. A fine bed.
I mean it, Daddy. Stop.
Come on, sugar. It's the American dream. Find anything you want.
I ain't interested in an American dream. Just an ordinary life. Easy days and quiet nights. Lazy walks beside a street. Now that's what you call a dream.
But Blanche, you and me, we could.
No ideas and no big plans.
If that's the landlord, you tell him I'm not here.
Good evening, Sheriff, Deputy. Is there anything we can help you with?
We thought that you might have some idea of your brother's whereabouts.
I have no idea where Clyde is.
He doesn't communicate with you?
Nope.
Two brothers get arrested together, break out of prison together. Seems to me you boys are real close. I find it hard to believe you don't keep in touch.
Like I said.
Or maybe a couple of weeks in jail.
No! Clyde writes us is all.
Did he tell you he killed my deputy?
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Is Bonnie with him?
Yes.
I want the letters.
I burn them after reading them.
We could lock you up right now.
For what?
Corresponding with a fugitive.
He doesn't write back. You can't arrest a man for receiving mail.
You hear from Clyde Barrow again. We want the letter.
And you tell him I will not rest until I get him. And I will get him. Same as I'm going to get you again one of these days.
Go to hell.
No. No, please. No, he's a good man.
He is a piece of shit. Just like his brother.
About you.
I'm okay.
And Bonnie.
We're okay.
Papers say you killed a police officer. I don't know you anymore, do I? Not since you went to that prison.
It was him or me, Ma.
It's not safe for you to be here anymore. The laws keep coming round.
I want
to
see you again.
I don't think.
I'll get a letter to you.
No.
And Pat, and we'll meet somewhere.
I wanna wear diamonds once done.
day. Depression and bread lines are all that tomorrow will bring.
Tell him, Clyde.
The Bible has got it wrong. Just look at the poor. The meek don't inherit a thing.
There is nothing good enough for us kids. We deserve all we are gonna get. This world should be notified. It'll be a bumpy ride. Thanks to Bonnie.
Everybody, this here's a holdup. I don't want to see nobody with their hands lower than their ears.
Bob Barrow and Bonnie Parker, ain't ya?
Why, yes we are.
Could I get an autograph?
Sure.
To Archie, if you would.
All the best, Bonnie and Clyde.
Why's your name gonna go first?
Bonnie and Clyde sounds better than Clyde and Bonnie.
Clyde and Bonnie sounds just fine to me.
Bonnie and Clyde rolls off the tongue better. There's a melody to it.
Hey, Archie, what do you think sounds better? Clyde and Bonnie or Bonnie and Clyde?
Clyde and Bonnie.
Shoot, he's just saying that because you've got the gun. Now what you like better? See?
We'll talk about this when we get home. Now, my partner here is going to approach the counter with a bag that I would very much like for you to fill with cash.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
Don't you see this gun, mister?
I can't figure a bag with cash because there isn't any.
This here is a bank, ain't it?
Yes, but
what the hell is going on here?
The bank is closed.
Then what are all these people doing here?
We're trying to get our damn money.
They're saying the bank is broke.
There's not a nickel in the drawers.
You're telling me I'm robbing a bank with no money?
Complaint forms are over there.
The bank owns every piece of land in the country. Everybody's home, everybody's damn farm. How can there be no money?
And who are we supposed to sell the farms to? Ain't nobody got enough money to buy them in the first place.
I should shoot you right now.
Come on, Clyde.
What kind of stupidity?
Come on, baby.
I lived in a camp damn near 3 years. Bank took the farm and nearly everybody I know.
And mine.
They took all our land.
Who let him have it, Clyde?
No money in a bank? What the hell has this country come to?
Gotta go to him. He needs me.
I need you, Daddy. I need you.
Clyde's been shot. He's in trouble.
Clyde's always in trouble. He's always gonna be in trouble. He's not your responsibility.
He's my brother. Maybe I can get him to stop running and come back.
It's too late for Clyde.
It's never too late. You taught me that.
Don't you walk out that door.
I gotta go, Branch.
You're not going because you want to bring Clyde back.
There's nothing here for me. Come with me, baby.
You walk out that door, Daddy. It's over. I mean it.
Thank you.
I'm okay.
I can't do it.
Just get a good firm grip on the bullet and yank it out.
I can't.
Don't think about it. It's just like removing a splinter.
There's a hell of a lot more blood here than a splinter, and I can see clear inside your shoulder.
I don't need to see that. Come on, close your eyes, close your eyes. Feel for the bullet. Pinch it hard between your fingers and pull.
Jesus, that was disgusting. You okay?
I'm fine.
I figured we'd be halfway across the country by now.
Well, we're out of West Dallas.
I want to stop running.
You just got to lay low
for
a while.
I'm sick of running.
You got to keep moving.
And driving. I'm sick of the car. I want to settle down.
We settle down? I'm dead.
So this is it?
Sugar.
This is our life?
Sugar.
I should have left you when I had the chance.
Come on. We'll find some place to lay low for a while. The cops are looking for us in Kansas, but we're fine so long as we stay here in Oklahoma. We'll find an apartment. Something nice. Read me a poem, sugar.
You heard them all.
Read me.
And the one I'm working on now ain't done.
Read me what you got. Read me anything.
I ain't done yet.
I don't care.
Okay. But I ain't done.
I understand.
You've heard the story of Jesse James, of how he lived and died. If you're still in need of something to read, here's the story of Bonnie and Clyde. Nothing rhymes with Clyde and Bonnie.
How about, Okay, go on.
Bonnie and Clyde are the Barrel Gang. I'm sure you all have read how they rob and steal, and those who squeal are usually found dying or dead.
Like that there bank teller. Bam, bam, bam.
There's a lot of untruths to these write-ups. They're not as ruthless as that. Their nature is raw. They hate all the law. They steal pigeons, spotters, and rats.
You got the lingo, baby. You got the lingo. You should send it to the papers. They print it.
Really? You think they'd publish it?
They'd print anything that's got to do with the two of us.
Oh, my God. I'm gonna be published.
Cold-blooded killers. They say they are heartless and mean, but I say this with pride.
That I once knew Clyde when he was honest and upright and clean.
Governor Ferguson.
What brings you here, Governor?
That bitch has killed 4 people, and they're printing her poetry like she's Emily friggin' Dickinson. We look like fools. I got a warden who can't keep criminals locked up, and I got a sheriff who can't catch them when they escape.
Governor, in all fairness...
Fairness! 2 police officers and 2 civilians are dead. And in public opinion, Bonnie and Clyde are heroes. There is no fairness, Sheriff.
I swear to you, we are on their trail, Governor.
I've read the reports. You have no idea where the hell they are.
You know what I'm working with here. No money... No resources. I got 3 deputies sharing 2 guns, for Christ's sakes!
We almost had him in a roadblock, but the guy drives like the devil. Before you know it, he's at the state line.
That's because Clyde steals the fastest cars out there. You drive the slowest cars built. Your cars weren't built for speed. They were built for back roads. Which is why, even if you caught him, you couldn't catch him.
Who the hell are you?
Frank Hammer.
I contacted retired Texas Ranger Captain Frank Hammer and convinced him to accept a commission.
A commission to do what?
Hunt down Bonnie and Clyde. Gentlemen.
Mm-hmm.
True detective says the cops are looking for us in Louisiana and Missouri. Oh, and listen to this. Escaped with Bonnie Parker, the ravishing redhead.
That's you, sugar.
Ravishing. I like that. It's more than beautiful. It's...
you.
Oh, I wish there was a picture. They should have a picture to go alongside this.
We don't need pictures. This job is hard enough. Pictures is the last thing we need.
I'm just saying it'd be nice to have a big picture right alongside where it says Ravishing Redhead. Or the cover. Oh, I want my picture on the cover. Who we gotta hold up to get my picture on the cover?
You don't need a picture, baby. When someone's seeing your face, there ain't no way they're ever gonna forget it.
Well, you're just partial.
Hell, I am. I start dreaming about my Bonnie.
Oh, you wrote a song for me.
From the minute I wake up.
Oh, you are so in love, sugar.
And that feeling is the best I ever had.
Ravishing and a song. This is a fine day.
She is in my shaving mirror. She is in my coffee cup. I must feel love. Or else I'm going mad.
You know, this might just be the finest...
Are you going to keep interrupting me?
Oh, I'm sorry.
I can't sing if you're going to keep interrupting
me. I won't say another word.
There is a rhythm and flow to these things.
I understand.
I would like to write to Bonnie, tell the girl the way I feel. But I'm better with the car than with the pain. Used to be I'm only happy when I'm sat behind the wheel. Now I don't care if I ever drive again. That girl's got something, nothing scares her. Only a piece of love that's ever come my way. Can't wait to tell her how much I've missed her. Feeling sorry for James Cagney, 'cause he never kissed her. I start dreaming about my body just as soon as I'm asleep. They're the kind of dreams that keep you in your bed. I am making love to Bonnie, and that sure beats counting sheep. Got a feeling there are good times up ahead.
Did you hear something?
No.
Get the lights.
Anything?
Shh.
It's Buck.
Hey.
Anyone follow you?
No, I swear. Just Blanche.
Where's your horse?
They're fashionable and comfortable in the car.
Son of a bitch, you came.
Of course.
Your brother came to try and talk
Blanche.
You to coming back to turn yourself in.
Blanche.
If I turn myself in, I'll get the chair. And as happy as that would make you, I think I'll pass. Come on, I'll show you around.
Hey, Buck, did you see True Detective? They called me a ravishing redhead.
Redhead, please. That was not a judgment, Lord. Just my professional opinion.
Thank you.
Bonnie. Bonnie.
Mama.
Oh, my God, my baby, are you all right?
I'm okay, Mama.
My precious baby, listen to me. You've got to give yourself up. You've got to.
Mama, you remember Clyde?
Evening, Miss Parker. Been a while. Bonnie does nothing but talk about you. She's always telling me how much she loves you and misses you. And I told her she can come see you anytime she wants. We can always find a way. We will always find a way. And I want you to know that I'm taking real good care of Bonnie and that I love her more than anything else in the world. Oh, and we also got you this. There's $20 inside. We know how hard times is, and we want to help in any way we can. I'll give you two some privacy.
I know how hard this must be for you, Mama, but I swear Clyde's a good man.
Listen to me, baby.
He loves me.
Bonnie.
Like a poet, he loves me.
Bonnie.
I'm okay. I just missed you is all.
Listen to me. Ted says that you'll only get a
Mama.
Prison.
Mama.
And while it's bad still and all, it's Mama. Nothing. I would be happier with you in prison than like you are, honey.
I'm not gonna leave him.
Listen to me! I can't live like this. I can't live knowing you could be dead any minute.
I'm the only one alive, Mama. Me and Clyde are the only ones alive in this goddamn place. Everybody's walking around dead but me and Clyde. I gotta go.
No.
I gotta go, Mama.
Don't go, baby, please.
I'll see you again soon.
Don't go. I'm begging you.
We'll get a message to you, and we will meet someplace soon. I promise.
Don't go, Mommy. Please.
And now, I've got Hoover and Roosevelt breathing down my damn neck.
Oh, why the hell are they getting involved?
Because Barrow and his brother broke into the West Texas Armory.
What do they take?
Enough weapons to start a small war. 3 Tommy guns.
Holy shit. Holy shit!
It's the end of a small town to get. Say goodbye.
Side of the Mississippi.
What the hell are you planning?
I want to walk down Main Street with Clyde Barrow's head on a stick.
Just get me within 300 yards of him, and I'll put a bullet through his neck.
Since when are we getting the business of murdering people?
Speaker Sheriff's Office said they had a bank robber a few hours ago. Barrow gang.
How do they know?
Parker signed autographs. Another teller was killed.
Matching the description of the Barrow gang, have been living at 1521 Joplin Street for the past 3 weeks. And get this, when the garage door was open, a neighbor saw a box of guns.
If we drive through the night, we'll be in Joplin midday tomorrow.
We don't have jurisdiction in Missouri.
I don't give a crap about jurisdiction.
I was hired to do a job. Now let's go get him.
All I wanna do is save her. That is all that matters now. Clyde took everything God gave her. I won't rest until I finally see.
Doing God knows what, and you can just sit there like that?
Yes, I can.
You're as crazy as he is.
You keep talking like that, you might just be the first person I kill.
You two deserve each other.
Yes, we do.
I don't understand. You're an attractive woman. You could have any man you set your sights on. Why are you here?
Why are you here, Blanche?
I'm here to stop my husband from being killed because for some reason he feels obliged to be here.
Maybe there's just not enough excitement to keep him at home.
Our life would be perfect if it wasn't for you and Clyde.
You just think you're so much better than everybody else, don't you, Blanche?
I'm just trying to be the best person I can in the eyes of the Lord.
And is that being fun, Blanche? You enjoying life?
I'm grateful for every day I spend on God's good earth.
Take a look around, Blanche. God's good earth is dried up. It's dead.
You are so completely and utterly lost. All I can do is pray for you.
Don't waste your time, Blanche. I have everything I want.
You know they're probably going to kill Clyde when they catch him.
If they catch him.
And they're probably going to kill you, too.
They better.
You can't tell me you ain't scared.
Dying ain't so bad. Not if you both go together. Only when one's left behind does it get sad. But a short and loving life, that ain't so bad. I only hope to God that I go first. I couldn't live on memories. I'm sorry, but I'm not that strong. There are some things in life you can't replace. Love like ours don't happen twice when all his days are through. Mine will be too. 'Cause dying ain't so bad. Not if you both go together. Only when one's left behind does it get sad. But a short and loving life, that ain't so bad. I've met boys who talk about farms and horses.
How are you, sugar?
Hey, baby.
Hey, baby.
Where were you?
Prescott.
What were you doing in Prescott?
Having lunch.
And robbing a bank.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Police near caught us, but man, you should see Clyde drive.
It just don't get no better than this. Ford the Lancer.
Wait till you see what I got you.
Did you steal it?
No, I bought it. You know, with the money we stole from the bank. Here. Try some of these.
Oh, my God. That is the most heavenly thing I've tasted in my whole life.
Yeah. Mm. Guy at a general store in Texarkana. Guy said it's just come out. It's called a Twinkie.
That was the Good Rich Sippers Orchestra, featuring the incomparable Henry Burr. Now, how about a dance?
Baby, it's our song.
Come on, sugar. Sing for us. The beautiful redhead.
Ravishing.
The ravishing redhead who held up your bank will now hold up your heart with her rendition of How About a Dance.
How about a dance? What do you say? I got some moves that I'd love to show you. Let's find a spot and dance the night away.
Ain't she something?
I know I'm not dancing with you.
How about a dance? It's always fun. Come over here. Let me get to know you. Can't be the man to lift your spirit high.
What's the matter, Clyde?
The law's outside.
What? Oh, my God, no. You have to turn yourself in. No, Daddy, don't.
Shut her up.
We are going to die. We're going to get shot. I'm going to die.
Shut up.
There's one over here by the tree.
There's another behind the white car.
Two more coming around the back. What are you gonna do, Clyde?
We're gonna shoot our way out. Just like we did in Bellevue.
No, no!
Me and you, we're gonna go down to the garage. We're gonna get the automatics out of the car. And we're gonna open up the doors, guns firing.
No, look.
Let's scare the shit out of them.
We're gonna get out. You're still firing. Start shooting from up here.
Okay, baby.
I promise. We're going to get out of this.
It all comes so quick, and it happens so fast. You're there, and they're there. They've got guns, and you've got guns. And you know it's going to be you or them. And you ain't got time to think about anything else. So you grit your teeth, and you come down hard in it, and then it's over and done. You killed a man. And you'll see him lying there, if you've time to wait and look. Life's gone, and you took it. And he'll never live and breathe and laugh again. But if he beat you to it, it'd be you lying there. It's messed up, the whole business. Them killing you, you killing them. You wonder why you were born, why anybody was born, why God should bother with this whole damn mess. Right, Sheriff? Better, sugar?
My leg's burning.
You think you're gonna be able to walk?
I don't think so. Buck needs treatment.
They're on our tail, Blanche.
He needs a hospital.
We can't go to a hospital.
He needs a doctor.
He's beyond doctor.
He's your brother.
You're flesh and blood, and you're just going to leave him here to die.
I think you should come with us.
I'm not leaving him.
Go with him, baby.
No. No. You're an animal! Don't you give up on me.
Sorry, Blanche.
Don't you be sorry. You just stay with me. You hear?
I didn't think it was going to be like this.
I know.
I just wanted to get us started.
We're going to move on from here. We're going to put all this behind us. You just stay with me, Daddy.
I want you to go back home, Blanche.
I'm not leaving you. You're going to get better, and we're going to go someplace nice, someplace far away. Don't you remember New Mexico, Daddy?
I do, baby.
No one needs
to see you.
Turn to him. When you do, his light will shine, and peace will come. No! You killed him! He was a good man, and you killed him!
Open.
Blanche Barrow, you were under arrest for the aiding and abetting known fugitives. Armed robbery, bank robbery, suspicion of murder.
He is there to lead the way for you through each night and day. God's arms are always open. Your voice is always heard, even though your prayers are silent prayers, he hears every word. No one needs to feel alone. Turn to him, and when you do, his light will shine. Will come to you. God's arms are always open, and everyone's his friend. When you find him, all your darkest fears will come to an end. Fears come to an end. Got the photos from the camera in Joplin.
Look at them. Looks like they're celebrating.
This is Bonnie and her mother.
What's with the rabbit?
This wasn't taken that long ago, which means they came back here so Bonnie could visit her ma. When's the last time they were in Dallas?
October. And before that, April.
Easter? Explains the rabbit.
And what were they here for in October? Halloween? You got any pictures of them with a pumpkin?
What's the date in October?
14th.
That's Bonnie's mother's birthday.
So you're telling me two murderers are risking capture just so they could see their folks?
I think so.
You haven't staked out the parents?
They've never had the money or the manpower.
Get a wiretap on the parents' phones.
We'll take turns staking out the homes.
And get those pictures of the papers.
When we find out where they're headed, we can scout the route and find a good vantage point. We can hit the car there with automatics.
We're not going to open fire on a moving vehicle.
Yes, we are.
No, we're going to try for an arrest.
They shot their way through 9 officers in Joplin. including a sheriff. Sheriff,
Clyde Barrow has no intention of giving himself up. Ever.
What about Bonnie?
Her fate was sealed the day she busted him out of East Ham. Next time they see their folks, will be the last.
I still see the apple cheek girl that you were, hiding in treetops and feeding the birds, making up rhymes how you loved.
Take at least 15, 16 hours to get from here to West Dallas. Baby, if we don't leave soon, our parents are going to be stood in the middle of the woods all alone. And I know my mama's bringing food.
How am I meant to face my folks? I killed Buck.
No, you didn't.
They got to hate me.
No.
It's my fault he's dead.
Buck made his own decisions.
I should be dead, too.
We're going to be, baby. I'll finish my poem.
Not in the mood.
Someday they'll go down together and they'll bury them side by side. To few it'll be grief, to the law a relief, but it's death for Bonnie and Clyde. I'm sorry, baby. Nothing rhymes with Clyde and Bonnie. Seems you get to live your life just once, and if that's how it's gotta be,
say it like Annie. Lots of people say honey.
My mama says honey.
She's bringing biscuits and honey.